How many of you want to find your calling? How many of you want to make a change? What stops you? 10 years ago, I was frozen, helpless, stuck. I was studying immunology, and I hated it. But I was so focused on pleasing the people around me, my teachers, my parents, who were doctors, that I didn't stop to ask myself what it is that I wanted to do. But over the past 10 years, I've genuinely come to believe that each one of us has the power to shape our own lives. We can choose what we do and who we become. I also think, and this is very important, you cannot please other people unless you please yourself first. But where do you start when it comes to designing your own life? I think you have to begin by asking yourself two simple questions. One, what am I good at? And two, what do I enjoy doing? But note, these two things are not always the same. You can enjoy watching films or TV, but that does not make you a good producer, director, or writer. So, how do you actually begin to ask yourself and answer these questions? A lot of people will tell you, ask your family and friends for feedback. But I actually think that asking the people around you is not that helpful, because people can only comment on what you're doing today. But if you actually want to make a big change, if you don't want incremental feedback, I think you have to do two things. One, look at your past. Take the time to ask yourself what it is that you chose to do as a child. How did you spend your free time? Also, and I really think there's no substitute for this, make sure that you try. You have to experiment to find out what you're good at. So if you've been waiting to write that piece of music, that piece of fiction, try a new sport, try. I know this is hard. Change is uncomfortable. It takes time. But if you want to grow, you need to stay uncomfortable. So get out of your comfort zone. For me, when I asked myself these questions, it was very obvious that medicine was not the right path. I hated being in a lab, watching cells grow. And also, I really don't like the sight of blood or injections. So what was I doing, trying to become a doctor? But that's just a starting point. When you figure out that you're in the wrong place, I think the real magic starts when you combine what you're good at and what you enjoy doing in a way where you uniquely express yourself. Everyone has a unique voice and identity, and you need to find that way to express yourself. When I look back at my past, when I tried to connect the dots, I saw that at the age of 4, I'd written my first book, very ironically, a biography. At the age of 9, I started my first startup, which was a library, which, let me tell you, is a terrible business model. Do not enter the world of library startups. But basically, the consistent theme or thread in my life was I loved reading, I loved writing, and what I really cared about doing was storytelling. I think stories really have the power to change people's hearts, to change people's minds, to help people connect, to help people develop empathy. So I decided I want to be a storyteller. We are a storytelling platform where we make shows for Netflix, for other platforms like YouTube. Basically, we're trying to tell untold stories to a changing India. You might have seen our show, Little Things, which is on Netflix. But basically what we're trying to do is create relatable characters where you feel like you can see yourself on screen. Growing up, I didn't have that. But that's just one of the things I do. I'm also a poet. So I've published my first book of poetry, Boundless, last week, which I'm very excited about. But for me, this is the start. Who knows? Maybe one day I'll make films, maybe I'll start my own channel, maybe I'll do podcasts. But I know that what I want to do is tell stories. I think you can choose your own path. What you need to do is reflect. Take the time to ask yourself what it is you enjoy doing. Try, because there's no substitute for trying and failing. I have failed many times over the last 10 years, made a lot of wrong choices. And importantly, find your unique voice and expression of yourself. For you, it might not be storytelling, but take the time to find what that common thread is. Let me tell you a story about Boundless. I had no intention of becoming a poet or writing a book. But last summer, I was in London. I had lived abroad for 10 years, and I was on my way back to Mumbai. I grew up in Mumbai. My parents live here. My in-laws live here. But to me, it didn't feel like coming home because I felt like I had experimented and changed so much that I was a different person. So honestly, I had a lot of fears and concerns about coming back, being a working woman in India, managing work and family. And so I started writing these poems as a way to express my own fears and feelings just to myself. So I was writing these poems on my phone. But through the process of writing, I realized that actually just the process of explaining myself to myself was so freeing and helpful that I thought, you know what? Why don't I share these poems? Maybe it will be helpful to someone else. So in a very millennial way, I put the poems on Instagram. Ended up having such a good reaction on social media that I decided to publish this book. But if I hadn't experimented, if I hadn't tried, I wouldn't have this book. So do not wait for the right time. Don't wait for permission. Start. Start today. I want to leave you with a poem from my book, Boundless. I did what I was told. Got good at coloring within the lines. Having the right answer. Pleasing teachers. I coasted, relying on my memory. But I wasn't ready. I couldn't handle myself or my heart or read others' minds. Break some rules while you're in school. Learn to fail and bounce back from mistakes because there is no reward for learning to color within the lines.